Welcome back. You're watching Election Exchange. Earlier today, we caught up with the royal family of Kota, Ajay Raj Singh and his wife Kamala Devi, who left the Congress party just about a week ago to join the BJP. Why did they do this at the 11th hour? Let's find out. Why the change at the last moment? That is what many people would ask.
Well, it was felt by the workers and by the family that our needs and requests for involvement in party posts and seats, etc., were not being listened to or heeded. So the workers were quite upset, and hence when the offer came to my wife, Kalpana Deviji, from the chief minister that we'd like you to fight from Ladpura, it was a respect given by them to our family, and we thought it's worth doing it. So that's why it was taken up.
Farmers' distress, that's a key issue in the area. Wherever we go, people talk about not getting the right price for garlic. They talk about farmers' suicides in the area. They talk about being ignored despite that Prabhu Lal Saini is from here. So how were you dealing with this anger?
I think our Chief Minister, Maharani Sahiba, is committed to making sure, along with our Prime Minister, to increasing the income of the farmers. So while we focus on increasing production, I think their focus is also into increasing processing, which would help them get a better price.
Right. That's another question that I'd like to ask you as well. In this entire Hadoti belt, farmers' distress would be a key issue. There are about 17 seats, and farmers could decide the fate of those seats as well. So is it really the right time to leave the Congress and join the BJP when there is so much of anger?
Look, the BJP has taken steps to help the farmers. They have waived farmer loans. They have increased the minimum support price, which I think will go a long way in helping the farmers become strong and get a certain good price for their produce from the land. The BJP has been taking steps. They have been involved with the farmers. I personally have been, and my wife, we've been involved with farmer issues since the last 10 years. So we have full confidence that they will see that we are working for them.
Was there anger at being ignored by the Congress from here?
I don't know whether you want to call it anger or hurt.
What about you?
You've been an MP from here for 10 years.
Yes, I didn't get the question.
Is there anger also at being ignored by the Congress party?
Look, as I said, the workers and myself, we felt that we were not getting the representation and involvement in certain party posts and certain developments and in seats also. So hence, they all felt that it's not sensible to stay on. And when the offer came from the Chief Minister for Kalpana Deviji to stand from Ladpura, we decided it should be taken up, and that's why she's fighting the election.
What is the one thing that you would like to change about the city of Kota? When we move around, people talk about women's safety, people talk about lack of hygiene.
Yes, I'd definitely like to focus. Being a woman, it would be a primary issue for me to focus on how to improve things for women, girl students, because we have a lot of coaching institutes here, and hygiene. There are so many issues. So we start, being a woman, I would like to start with women's issues.
The city of Kota is also known for coaching institutes. We caught up with students and faculty members at the Allen's Coaching Institute, who spoke about the need for cleaner surroundings, more security for women, better connectivity, and also the high GST rate on coaching institutes.
Sir, I'd like to ask you, this is such a major coaching hub in the country. Lakhs of students come here every year. Are you happy with the kind of facilities that the government is providing in the city of Kota?
Actually, we need better connectivity from rest of the country, because lakhs of the students come here for their studies. Their parents want to come to Kota frequently, and we want to invite good faculties and resource person from outside also. But because of the lack of connectivity, we are not doing it so well. And that is why government should run its airport, commercial flights here. That will be definitely beneficial for Kota city.
Okay. What about you, sir? Do you feel that that the city is getting enough support?
Yes, लेकिन सफाई की व्यवस्था थोड़ी और अच्छी होनी चाहिए. जो पार्क्स हैं वो डेवलप होने चाहिए ताकि स्टूडेंट्स जो हैं वो उनमें खेल सकें, अच्छा कर सकें। बेसिकली स्टूडेंट डेंस एरिया में वाटर की प्रॉब्लम्स भी हैं, सड़क अच्छी नहीं है, तो उन पे भी गवर्नमेंट को ध्यान देना चाहिए।
18% GST काफी इम्पैक्ट पड़ा है, मेनी पेरेंट्स मस्ट बी टेकिंग लोन्स एंड सेंडिंग देयर स्टूडेंट्स हियर, डू यू थिंक दैट इज इम्पैक्टिंग द पेरेंट्स एंड द स्टूडेंट्स एज वेल?
Yes, it is impacting very much to the parents as well. As we know that the fees, if we include the GST, 18% GST, the government is imposing on this sector. So we must demand to reduce the GST for the betterment of the students and also for the society. If the 18% GST will be imposed on the students, then it will be very much cost on the parents.
बहुत महंगा पड़
जाएगा। बहुत महंगा है।
बहुत
महंगा। 18%.
Okay, let's quickly get in a word from some students also who are here. What kind of changes would you like in the Kota city?
Look, I really want there's a need an airport here because there are some students which are from various parts of the country which are very large distances from this Kota. So I really need an airport here.
How happy are you when it comes to women's safety, women's security? How do you rate Kota?
If we talk about women's safety, so I think it's safe in LN, but if we are going outside the LN, so it's not that safe, which it should be, because if I think safety should be on the top priority for any leader, if it comes to girls especially, so that lot of girls can come forward and can achieve what they really want to and concentrate on the studies for what we have come here.
Okay. So if you had to send out one message about your wish from the election, what would that be?
So, जैसे कि एलिंग की फैसिलिटीज तो बहुत अच्छी है, लेकिन फॉर एग्जाम्पल हम लोग यहाँ रात के 9 बजे 9:30 तक पढ़ते हैं, घर से कॉल आती है कि आप घर जल्दी आ जाओ, क्योंकि तो हम चाहते हैं कि कोटा में मतलब गर्ल्स या वुमेंस के लिए एक अच्छा माहौल, क्या वो फ्री माहौल होता कि वो मतलब रात में भी अच्छे से मतलब पढ़ने के बाद भी 9:30 से 10 आराम से अच्छे से जा सके। तो सो वी वांट जस्ट कि एक बहुत ही फ्रेंडली माहौल, एक अच्छा माहौल, सेफ माहौल मिले, और मैं चाहती हूँ कि प्राइम मिनिस्टर आजकल के जनरेशन यूथ पे, उनके एडुकेशन पे ज़्यादा ध्यान दें, क्योंकि अगर हमारी यूथ ज़्यादा पढ़ी लिखी होगी तो आने वाली फ्यूचर ज़्यादा अच्छी होगी। तो वी वांट जस्ट कि हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर मतलब सारे सिर्फ इसी फील्ड में नहीं, सारे एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड है उसमें भी हम काफ़ी पीछे हैं, तो हम चाहते हैं कि हमारी गवर्नमेंट सारे फील्ड्स पे अच्छे से काम करे, अच्छे अच्छे लोगों को चूज करके अपने कैबिनेट में डाले, काफ़ी पढ़े लिखे लोगों को डाले,
गुड लीडर्स,
गुड लीडर्स
टू लीड यू। डू यू ऑल्सो थिंक दैट रिलीजन, व्हेन इट कम्स टू पॉलिटिक्स, व्हेन इट कम्स टू इलेक्शंस, लीडर्स शुड स्टॉप हार्पिंग ऑन रिलीजन एंड कास्ट?
Yes, sir, of course, it should not be there, because first of all, India is a democratic country, it's a secular country, so you should not be that biased ki aap sirf casteism pe ja rahe ho ya fir kuch kar rahe ho, aap apni taraf se aapko pura apna best dena chahiye, of course, because we are choosing a leader who's gonna rule us for 5 years. So generally hota kya hai ki jab elections aa jate hain to government becomes very active, 1-2 महीने में सारे डेवलपमेंट करके दिखाएंगे, सो दैट्स रियली वेरी फेक, बिकॉज आपको वो पूरे 5 साल जो आपका रूलिंग सेशन है उसमें वो आपको करना चाहिए, एंड इट्स नॉट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली पर्टिकुलर गवर्नमेंट, बट इट्स बिकॉज इट्स द ड्रामा ऑफ होल द पॉलिटिक्स, सो दैट्स वॉट आई थिंक होना चाहिए। एंड सेकेंडली आई विल कंसिडर दैट ऑल्सो कि आर प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज़ इनिशिएटेड सच अ ब्यूटिफुल प्रोग्राम स्वच्छ भारत अभियान, बट यू कैन नॉट फाइंड दैट बींग इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन कोटा, एंड नॉट इन कोटा बट all over India. You can find various animals straying here and there, pigs and cows. There's a risk on main road, there's a risk of accidents. So it's not safe. How can you then consider Kota in a smart city?
How can Kota be a smart city when you lack cleanliness, when there are no adequate medical facilities, transport facilities are lacking, and there is a lack of connectivity as well? So those were the words from some very bright students and faculty members here in Kota. Let's hope our leaders who are fighting this election are listening. The Prime Minister spoke about Rajasthan as a major textile manufacturing state. We actually traveled to the textile manufacturing hub in Rajasthan, the city of Bhilwara. Traders there and manufacturers were upset over high electricity prices, which they said were the highest in the country. Take a look at this report.
Bhilwara city, located at a distance of 260 kilometers from Jaipur, is one of India's biggest textile manufacturing hubs. In fact, 60% of the country's synthetic fiber production comes from these weaving units. Bhilwara has 500 textile manufacturing units with an annual turnover of over 21,000 crore rupees. Approximately 1 lakh people work in these industries and another 60,000 would be employed indirectly. Home to companies like Hindustan Zinc, Bhilwara is clearly an industrial powerhouse. But traders here complain that business is down by at least 20% because of high electricity prices and the recent ban on the use of pet coke.
आने वाले जो भी सरकार आवे, हम चाहेंगे कि भाई electricity rate कम से कम 2 रुपए unit कम करनी चाहिए. दूसरा ये है कि pet coke को allow करना चाहिए क्योंकि coal India से कोयला ही नहीं मिल रहा है. इतना कोयला महंगा आ रहा है और pet coke से हमारी cost भी कम पड़ती है. तो जब हमारे दूसरे पड़ोसी states हैं मध्य प्रदेश महाराष्ट्र ये गुजरात ये यूज कर रहे हैं तो आज हम तो उनके सामने टिक ही नहीं सकते हैं तो इसलिए आप देखेंगे हमारा यहाँ का प्रोडक्शन पिछले 6 महीने में 25% के आसपास कम हो चुका है.
इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट्स हियर से दैट दे हैव टू शेल आउट 7.8 रुपीस फॉर एवरी यूनिट ऑफ पावर व्हिच इज द हाईएस्ट टैरिफ इन द कंट्री. व्हाइल देयर इज अप्रिसिएशन फॉर द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स एफर्ट्स इन ब्रिंगिंग इन राजस्थान इन्वेस्टमेंट प्रमोशन पॉलिसी and reducing GST rates, members of the Mewar Chambers of Commerce admit that many of their requests have fallen on deaf ears.
Demonetization and GST, the sales have gone down. Production has also been affected. It has gone down by almost 25%.
जो बांग्लादेश से जो 0% ड्यूटी के ऊपर जो ये कपड़ा इंपोर्ट किया जा रहा है जब तक इसके ऊपर बैन नहीं लगेगा तो ये जो दुनिया की वर्ल्ड क्लास की मशीन्स के ऊपर जो लेटेस्ट प्रोडक्शन जिसमें डेनिम पर्टिकुलर एक आइटम भीलवाड़ा ने 1.5 करोड़ मीटर पर मंथ के ऊपर हम प्रोडक्शन पे आ चुके हैं इसकी मार्केटिंग के लिए हम लोगों को एक बहुत बेसिकली प्रॉब्लम आ गई. इस प्रॉब्लम को दूर करने के लिए हमारी तरफ से सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट से हम ये डिमांड करते हैं कि जो जैसे कि बाकी कंट्रीज से जो भी इंपोर्ट होता है उस पर 20% इंपोर्ट ड्यूटी लगती है तो बांग्लादेश से जो कपड़ा आ रहा है वो 0% ड्यूटी पर आ रहा है.
द नीरव मोदी मेहुल चोकसी स्कैम, डू यू थिंक दोज इंसिडेंट्स हैव मेड इट मोर डिफिकल्ट फॉर ट्रेडर्स एंड बिजनेसमैन टू गेट लोन्स?
यस, बिकॉज मेनी ऑफ द बैंक्स दे हैव कम अंडर द पीसीए. सो वंस दे हैव कम अंडर द पीसीए they start stop lending unless after stopping the lending that where the entrepreneur will go even the rate of interest and the what you call the limits that has been reduced. So when you talk about the 3 point, one is the availability of the credit that is not, because most of the banks they have stopped, we are not able to lend it. So unless we are able to get a finance, how the industry will prosper it?
At present Bhilwara is mainly a weaving hub with only 19 processing units. Businessmen here hope that the next government would look into their demand of increasing water supply so as to encourage more processing units.
Textile manufacturers here in Bhilwara feel they haven't received enough attention from the government, despite the fact that this is the biggest textile manufacturing hub in India. Many of the issues they are facing have to be addressed by the central government, but manufacturers here have 3 key wishes from the next government in Rajasthan. Firstly, reduce electricity prices, make sure that traders, manufacturers get better credit facilities, and number 3, urge the central government to introduce the national textile policy at the earliest.
That's all the time we have on Election Exchange today, 7th December. That is when Rajasthan goes to vote. Let's see what happens on that day. Goodbye and thanks for watching.